In this screencast, we're going to show how to plot equations using Mathematica. These happen to be equations from mass and energy balances for adiabatic CSTR. And so there are two equations we're going to plot simultaneously. We're plotting the concentration of B versus temperature. And these two equations, one is linear and one is nonlinear. And what we want to do is plot the equation that depends on the temperature of the feed. We want to plot that for three values of the feed temperature on the same plot. So we'll switch over to the Mathematica program. So I've opened a new Mathematica notebook. So I'm going to first just copy in the various parameters that we're using here and just point out a couple things when doing this. I put a semicolon after each one of these, just meaning I don't want the value to be outputted when I run the program. And now I want to do is type in my equations. And so I'm going to define the variable for this concentration of B from the energy equation. Note that I'm using lowercase when I define all my variables for the first letter. That's because avoids confusion with functions, which start with a capital letter. And the format then is to use brackets to indicate the variables. The notation that's standard is the variable temperature with this underline symbol. So Mathematica, when I'm setting up an equation, I'm gonna use colon equal sign, and then I can type pretty much standard way the equation on the right side of the equal sign. Again, I put a semicolon and hit return. Now I'm going to type the other equation, which is only a function of temperature, but otherwise using the same formatting. I use the function for exponential. So anytime I use a function, I have brackets, as you can see here. This is basically what I now want to plot. If I hit return, and now I will put in what I want to plot, which is first this CB energy, again, square brackets. I want to plot this as a function of temperature, and I want to plot it for a specific value of the feed temperature, so 245. What I also want to do is plot this for other values of the feed temperature. So I can put a comma and the same function again. I'm plotting as a function of temperature, but I'm going to use 270 degrees. When I have more than one value that I'm plotting, I need to put that in the squirrely bracket, and I end up erasing the final bracket for my plot function, so let me put that back in. I could also then, inside these squirrely brackets, put a third condition. So that I'm plotting the equation for three values of the feed temperature. The other equation that I want to plot then is other function, CB mass, and this is only a function of temperature. These are four graphs, so I'm plotting them as a function of temperature, so I need to indicate again that my independent variable for the x-axis is temperature. And I'm going to plot from 240 degrees to 400 degrees. So now I have everything to generate the plot. And so I generate the plot by hitting Shift-Enter. So you can see I made a mistake. I only have three plots because I typed an extra letter for my function here. So if I remove that, again, hit Shift-Enter. Now I generate the plot with the four graphs that I'm looking at. The three CB energy plots are the straight lines, and the CB mass is this curved line. If I want the plot to look a little nicer, then I can put a comma here, and let's hit return. Here is the first plot option that I'm going to use. The plot range, the y-axis range is from now from 0 to 0.012, so removing this negative part of the plot. I hit return again, so I've added some additional options. add an additional option. So the frame is now labeled. So what I'm doing is labeling the x-axis with temperature, and the y-axis is CB, the concentration of B. Again, hit return. And plot style thickness. So again, a comma and return. And now I've added a plot label. Again, comma and return. And this says I want legends to label the individual plots. So this then is the last option I'm going to choose for the plot. And I should now be able to hit shift enter. And I've generated a plot with bigger fonts, with labels on the x and y axis, with a frame, a label of adiabatic CSTR, and then above it, this legend. By using two variables in my one plot, I can make multiple plots for different values of this temperature of the feed.